The dimensional analysis ideas that we have used also apply to higher powers. The only real difference is that when we're working with higher powers, we take the exponents and we apply them to both sides, the top and the bottom, of whatever our conversion rate is. Let's say that we had 1 foot, which we know for a fact is 12 inches. We will just square everything here. And if I do that, that means that 1 square foot is equal to 144 square inches. We can do the same with cubic inches. To see where this is true, imagine the little cube on the right-hand side is a cubic inch. And imagine the cube on the left-hand side is a cubic foot. Well, if I take this little cubic inch and I make 12 of them, we see that 12 of them still don't come out to as much as this big, big cube next to it. Now, if I continue and I make another 12 of what we have now, well, we have a lot of cubes now, but still not quite as many. Still not enough to fill in that entire box. In fact, it's not until we take all of these little cubes we just made and multiply those by 12 that we get the box itself. The one on the right looks a little bigger because of the gaps, but the two of them do indeed have the same volume now. So as you see, in order to get the same volume in cubic inches as we had in a single cubic foot, we had to go along three dimensions: height, width, and depth. And for that reason, to get an equivalence here, we have to cube these. And that means we have to find 12 to the third power, which is 1,728. So 1 cubic foot consists of, ultimately, 1,728 of those little inch cubes that we just observed. We can apply the same logic to conversion problems that involve converting between square or cubic units. Looking at this first one, a basketball has a volume of 455.9 cubic inches. We want to convert this to cubic centimeters. So we'll do exactly what we just did. We will take that exponent of 3, and we will apply it to everything here. Before you continue, you do need to find 2.54 to the third power. That comes out to 16.387064. So we can take 455.9 and multiply by 16.387064. That is what this will become when you cube it. As before, the cubic inch units will divide out. And also as before, 1 cubed you can ignore because 1 cubed is 1. And so this comes out to approximately 7,470.86 cubic centimeters. We can do the same thing on a much larger scale with the land area of Moses Lake, which is approximately 18.75 square miles. If we want to convert this to square feet, once again, we square everything here. 1 squared will be 1, but once again, we will have to compute 5280 squared ourselves. That comes out to a large number, 27,878,400 square feet. And so now we can take 18.75 and multiply by 27,878,400, which, as big a number as that is just a conversion between miles and feet, and once again, our square miles will divide right out. And while we're dealing with very large numbers here, the actual math itself has not actually changed that much. We end up with 572,720,000 square feet. And that is what it would take if you had tiles that were 1 foot by 1 foot to tile the entirety of Moses Lake.